morning and welcome to worship this morning. I invite you to rise and join us. If you are at home, please feel free to sing along. Sing with your heart to your heart's content. If you're here in the congregation, we ask that you look at the words on the screen, meditate on them, hum so that we're not projecting spit to the world. So just please hum along and meditate on those words. I know a place.
Where we can go to lay the troubles down, eating your soul. I know a place where mercy flows, takes the stains, makes you whiter than snow. Like a tide, it is rising up deep inside a current that moves and makes you come alive. Living water that brings the dead to life. From dusty roads into paradise. All of my dirt, all of my shame, drowned in streams that have made me born again. Like a tide, it is rising up deep inside a current that moves and makes you come alive. Living water that brings the dead to life. In amazing grace, let's go down, down, down to the river. Let's go down, down, down to the river. We're going down to the river, down to the river, down to the river to pray. In amazing grace, let's go down, down, down to the river. Let's go down, down, down to the river.
Please join me in the call to worship. Beautiful are the works of God.
Beautiful also are all of God's people.
Beautiful is the mind of God.
Beautiful also are the hopes of God's people.
Beautiful is the heart of God.
Beautiful also are the souls of God's people.
God made the heavens and the earth.
To God be the glory for the things God has done.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust.
Take our seats. Why don't we turn around and wave and smile at least three people. They can see the tell that we're smiling even behind our masks. This is our new passing of the peace. We're so glad you are here. I invite the congregation to be seated. My name is Matt Hadley, and I am the senior pastor here at the United Methodist Church of Whitefish Bay. And this is a day in which our membership is going to grow by seven fantastic human beings. It is Confirmation Sunday. I'm also so glad to be joined by so many at home. I know typically on Confirmation Sundays, there's more extended family that come and get to be a part of this celebration. So I know that many of you are related to and know and love one or more of these young people who are going to be confirmed with us this day. And throughout between the two services, the kids are helping out by leading. We already heard our call to worship done so beautifully, and Jacob is behind the scenes in the booth on the tech side of stuff as we continue to help to shape future ministries for people here. On your way in, we did give you our contact card, and once again, it's important that you fill this out. This is not for us to track membership, but this is in case we get word that somebody at the 9 o'clock service this Sunday has tested positive for COVID, they can do the contact tracing. But for those of you here in the sanctuary, if you would like to have an item of joy or concern to be voiced aloud during our time of community prayers, you can text it to that number. And for those of you at home, the prayer request number has been up on your screen, and we really do take prayer very, very seriously. Well, not only is this going to be a fun celebratory morning worship, there's good things that are happening outside as well. We have our food drive pickup and drop off for the Milwaukee Rescue Mission. And then immediately following the second service, if you are an educator, a teacher, or if you're a student, no matter what level, pursuing your PhD, or you have one who's just headed off to grade school for the first time, we're going to have a drive-by blessing of the bags and blessings of the school year. And so there's information about that on our webpage, but after the 10:30 service, I hope to see many of you come through right before kickoff, right? That'd be great. That'd be great. And so we continue in worship this day, and these young people who are not in even elementary or middle school anymore now, they began with us when they were little children, and we seek to be faithful to the young ones in our intergenerational congregation. And so let's receive this video children's moment incorporating some of our new stars.
Hi, you've almost made it to confirmation. Congratulations, now you get to be part of children's message. I'm gonna ask two questions, and I would love if you would send a video response to one or both of the questions. If you answer both questions, it's okay to split it into two pieces. So, here's my first question. What is a favorite memory from church from when you were younger? That could be last year, or 7 years ago, or, you know, yesterday. And my second question is, how would you like to serve at church going forward? That can be anything. And when I say at church, there's a lot of ways that we serve in church that aren't in our building. So feel free to be creative and serve God.
Hi, my name's Dylan Rice, and my favorite memory of the church was probably this past winter's retreat that Steve, Lori, and John took a couple of the fellow 7th and 8th graders to. And it was really fun and had a lot of fun memories there. And then my thing I'm looking forward to help serve the church is going to ASP for as long as I can, and helping with Faith Works.
Hi, I'm Eric Melia, and my favorite memory of church was my first day going to Camp Lucerne. One way I want to serve our church is giving back to others who need it more.
Hi, my name is Christian Zastava. My favorite part about being in the church was going to Camp Timberley. In a way, I am trying to serve the church in the future is by going to ASP mission trips.
Hi, my name is Aaron Gorham, and my favorite memory from the church is the Sunday school and doing the services, like putting the pumpkins in the truck and stuff, and donating. And how I'll serve the church, like ASP, I'll try to keep doing that for the rest of my life.
Hi, my name is Drew Ho. One thing that I really like about being in church was all the fun memories of rock. One thing that I want to do is help in the song.
Hi, my name is Luke Paulson, and my favorite memory from the past couple of years at church was going to Camp Lucerne. I really enjoyed it because I spent a lot of time with my friends and also got to worship God. One way I can serve God in church is doing community service and spending my time and also donating things to the less fortunate. Thank you. Bye.
Hi, you've almost made it.
We're going to shift to a time of morning prayer, and to get us into that prayerful attitude, Heather Pokey's going to sing a stanza of Sanctuary.
In the prophet Ezekiel, we hear the story of a vision. Ezekiel says, "The Lord took hold of me, and I was carried away by the Spirit of the Lord to a valley filled with bones. He led me all around among the bones that covered the valley floor. They were scattered everywhere across the ground and were completely dried out." And the people said, "All hope is gone." But the Lord spoke, "I will put my Spirit in you, and you will live again and return home to your land. Then you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken. I have done what I said." Yes, the Lord has spoken, said the prophet. And so we turn to God in prayer. O God, who always listens to us, who breathes new life into us, call us forward to resurrection. We are surrounded by a world of dry bones, a world of death and despair, a world where we lose hope in our structures, ourselves, and you. We pray for this world in need of your word, for all people in it, for those who lay down their lives, for those who lead. O God, who always listens to us, who breathes new life into us, call us forward to resurrection. We are surrounded by people with dried up lives, people unable to see your life past their tears. We pray for this world in need of your healing presence, for those who are imprisoned or those who are alone and isolated, for those who are ill or infirm, or those who are grieving. Lord, be with the Hootie family. These beautiful floral arrangements, a reminder of a celebration of life cut way too short. And so, O God, who always listens to us, who breathes new life into us, call us forward to resurrection. We are spellbound by these dry bones, terrified by the stink of death, and often too dumbfounded to call forth life in your name. We pray for all your people, your church. We pray for the courage not just to follow you to death, but to follow you to the new creation. And so now, Almighty God, hear the prayers of this community of faith, the prayers of your people, both gathered and scattered.
Prayers of healing for Marianne and Tom. Marianne's father and mother passed away peacefully within 24 hours of each other and are in a better place. As the priest pointed out in the funeral, they were married for 24,500 days and were only apart for 11 hours. Prayers of healing for Rick and Katie on the unexpected passing of Rick's father. Prayers of joy on the occasion of confirmation, and thanks for the faithful leadership and love of our confirmation teachers. Prayers for job, health, back to school, endurance. Shalom for all members. Prayers for the confirmands that they continue to seek, question, and grow in their faith. Pray for Maggie, who's being treated for mental health issues, and for Aunt Pat, who's awaiting results of a brain MRI. Prayer for Aunt Jenny and cousins grieving the loss of Dave. Prayers for Greg, who continues his battle with brain cancer. Prayer of thanks for the Christian care that Lynn Bennett has been showering on a family in need of comfort. These are the prayers of our people. Let's sing with Heather one more verse of Sanctuary.
O God, who always listens to us, who breathes new life into us, call us forward to resurrection. Call us to follow in the footsteps of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, who taught us when we pray to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. And so as we come to a time for offering, to reflect on the ways in which we continue to live beyond ourselves through our gifts of time, through our gifts of talent, and through the gifts of our treasure, and to help us meditate upon the ways in which we make offering to our God, we have a special musical number by Ellie.
This morning's scripture reading is from 1 Timothy chapter 4, verses 9 through 12. This is a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. That is why we labor and strive, because we have put our hopes in the living God, who is the Savior of all people, and especially of those who believe. Command and teach these things. Don't let anyone look down on you because you are young. But set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity.
The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Well, this is in between. This is a standalone Sunday, is what we call them, when it's not a part of a sermon series. We just finished up our sermon series last week on the hymns of Charles Wesley. And next week, we begin a six-week sermon series where I seek to address some difficult questions that people have asked me over my 30 years of ministry. Does God make mistakes? How can I know what God's will is for my life? How can I believe in a good God in a world that is so evil? We're going to be doing that one on World Communion Sunday. Why doesn't God answer my prayers? Does the divinity of Jesus really matter? On Reformation Sunday, we're going to ask the question, why do some questions lead to change and others not? I don't know how to ask. But friends, today we have a different set of six questions that at the 10:30 service, our young people who have been preparing for this with an A team of people who are giving so much of themselves to help to bring a faith that is alive. Six questions. Six questions that many of you have already answered, but do we take them for granted? Have our answers changed? Answers like that, or questions like this, on behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? How often do you read that? How often do you reflect on that? Question two, do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? Question three, do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, place your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church, which Christ has opened to people of all ages, all nations, and all races? According to the grace given to you, will you remain a faithful member of Christ's holy church? And will you serve as Christ's representative in the world? As members of Christ's Universal Church, will you be loyal to the United Methodist Church and to do all in your power to strengthen its ministries? And the final question is very specific to right here. As members, full members, at your age, full members, as much of a member of this community of faith as the leader or chair of any board or anyone who has been a member here for 60 or 70 years, you have equal standing after this day. And so we're going to ask you, will you faithfully participate in our ministries by your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness? And I think anyone who has taken membership vows in this community of faith should be checking themselves. Am I really praying for this church? Am I really present? Am I using my gifts in order to serve and to be a bright, shining light out in the world through witness? These are good questions, and these are questions that, of course, our young people have been prompted, because I'm going to say, if so, please say I do, or if so, please say I will. And there's great fear of grandma and grandpa, so I'm sure everyone's going to answer the way that they should answer. But I want to introduce Steve Lyerly. Steve is our young, hip director of youth ministries right now, and he has this great team put together. And so in order to prepare our young people to know how to even begin to answer those questions, what is your philosophy of confirmation? What are you and your team trying to do for these young people?
Well, one of the things we're trying to do is obviously establish a foundation for them to work from, to build their faith and to take with them on their faith journey. But we also want them to really begin to openly explore the questions that you've brought up so far, their questions about who and what is God, what is a faith journey, where and how do we serve the church, and where do we go from here in growing our faith and love for each other. And one of the third things we want to teach them is service to others. A lot of what we do in the church is loving other people, no matter who you are, where you are, and what the color of your skin is, what your orientation is. We want to teach them to learn to love each other, but to also serve each other, which you notice in the video, that was one of the questions. How will you serve the church from here on?
Excellent, excellent. So I have their faith statements here, and I have been able to glean nuggets out of each of these faith statements, and I want you to respond to some of this.
Okay.
All right. So I've been going to this church for 10 years, which means this individual started at 4 years old, probably, right? Are we 14 or 15 years old? So for 10 years, and have not thought about what church means to me. Is this young person telling me that because of their experience in confirmation, they've been prepped to try and think about what church really means to them?
Yes.
So what does church mean to you?
What the church means to me is it's beyond this building, and it's what we see going on throughout this community and throughout the world. And we are seeing these young people begin to make that connection that it's not just coming to hear on Sunday morning, but it's what we do when we leave here. One of my favorite things to watch them do is to make sandwiches. And I know the ham and cheese is the easiest, but the most entertaining is the peanut butter and jelly, because most of it doesn't end up on the bread. It ends up on the floor, and I have to clean it up later. But they understand the importance of what that bologna and cheese or peanut butter and jelly sandwich means to someone else. And it's more about feeding their hunger. It's about feeding their soul and acknowledging their value and worth as a human being.
Well, so this individual said the same kind of thing. You know, church is a place where I can help out, and talks about the homeless shelters. And it really taught me that we are lucky to be where we are. Amen. They go on to say, to me, church means a place of belonging, of community, a place to get closer to friends and to God. But one of the things I like about this is, this individual says, I've made new friends at church and found new influencers. And for a young person who is going into high school, how vital are the right influencers? How important is that? And finally said, I'm surrounded by caring and supportive people. Another person said, I have learned and noticed that God always has a purpose. This young person believes he puts you through struggles so you can overcome them and get stronger. He puts you through good and happy times so you can laugh and have fun. But they go on to say, to do good for the world and to give back. And I'm sure they learned the three rules of Methodism. That's one of the first things we teach in confirmation, right? There's only three real rules to be here. And they are, do no harm, do good, and stay in love with God, right? And that looks like loving God and loving neighbor. But to do good, to give back to the world. But this is one of the things I like. This person said, every day I use something that God has taught me. And one of the things this young person, in transitioning from the child faith into a faith of a young man, is I learned here the real meaning of Christmas and Easter. And I think that is something that needs to continue to be passed down, that these aren't just store events. These are close to our faith, very close to our faith. Another one here. I think of our church community as family, where we help each other grow and learn. And if one of us falls, we go over to help that person. And you know, our church mission statement says, love God, care for each other. That's that supportive,
that's right,
supportive thing. I can ask God for strength, and he's right there to help me through it. I know God is watching over me. And then goes on to say, and this is a critical thinker, at a religious school elsewhere, being taught at that school that being homosexual and acting out on it is a sin, as is taking your own life as a mortal sin. And there's something about that, that theologically, this young man was already thinking theologically about it. But I love this little sentence here. My relationship with God, I feel like, has always been special. The way Miss Lori brought me into the kids group when I was younger, that is what started my entire faith journey and my journey with God every step of the way. Every milestone, I am feeling closer and closer to God. Right now, I feel closer to him than I ever thought I would in my life. Step by step, milestone by milestone. You know, it's been a rough week when I have to go to the Book of Discipline. And this Book of Discipline is kind of how we guide ourselves. But listen to what it says about confirmation. There are many occasions as people mature in the faith when the Holy Spirit's confirming action may be celebrated, such as in the reaffirmation of the baptismal covenant or other services related to life passages. Moment by moment, as we continue to grow,
that's right,
can go deeper and deeper, like the deepest part of the ocean. Unlike baptism, which is a once-made covenant and can only be reaffirmed and not repeated, confirmation is a dynamic action. Did you guys know you were part of something dynamic? Confirmation is a dynamic action of the Holy Spirit that can be repeated. Confirmation is supposed to be a repeatable act. How, Steve, do you believe we can repeat our communion? What does that mean?
You know, for me, that means that every time we reconnect and I'm going to say that word again, not just reconnect, but every time we connect. That was one of the things that we tried to teach this year in confirmation, was making that connection to the church somewhere, somehow. But every time we make a connection to the church, but also come to a greater understanding of what the church is and how and where we can make that connection. That's that confirmation or reconfirming, because it can happen out in the streets, it can happen in the school, in the gymnasium, it can happen at home, it can happen just about anywhere, and it should happen everywhere.
Yeah, and at least once a year we have an opportunity for people to remember their baptism.
That's right.
And to reconfirm that. You know, one of the questions that they were going to answer, I read it earlier, do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? One of our young people said, Jesus, talking about who is God, who is Jesus, Jesus is a healer who loved all people and was intolerant of injustice. I think that young person gets what we're at.
That was an A plus.
A plus, right? Yes. Yeah. I believe in God and his doings. That's a strong sentence. I believe in God and his doings. One aspect about confirmation and worship I like is it teaches me important life lessons that everyone could, and I would say should, incorporate into their lives. And Neil would love this part, and he's back there behind the. My favorite part of worship. Now, this is a young person. My favorite part of worship is the choir, because they are trained singers and they are very good at it. And I'm sure that's the praise team too. Very, very, very good at it. But we know that music is a spiritual language. I like this one too. I attended the Tree of Life preschool at church.
Outstanding.
One of our ministries, with some of my friends that I am still friends with today. But talk about involvement. Wednesday Night Live, Ash Wednesday, Rock, Miss Sue's choir classes, Miss Christie's Sunday school classes, Miss Lori's Sunday school classes, Mr. Bubke's choir, pumpkin unloading. I even starred in church musicals. Camp Lucerne. And so this person who is actually not going to be confirmed today, because you are confirmed, you are reaffirming the vows your parents made at your own baptism. This young man's going to be baptized for himself. But he ends, his mic drop last sentence is, I believe in God and the Bible. I believe in God and the Bible. And then finally, my time with my church family has helped me grow and learn who I am and what faith means to me, which can be summed up in one sentence, to know that God is here and he is guiding me to be my best and find where I belong. Find where I belong. And there's always a place in the world for God's people. And so for the prayer, we heard about those dry bones. Church is dead. Following God is dead. But it's with each new generation that we know that God is still breathing life into bones that may appear to be dead. But for those of you who were confirmed a long, long time ago, we need to have that breath of God continue to blow in us and through us. We need to be intentional to find times to reconfirm, to confirm who we are, whose we are, and how we should live. And so thank you to the team. And so I'm done here. Why don't you give a recognition of your teachers and introduce who the young people are that next service are going to be confirmed.
Confirmed, absolutely. So let me introduce the teachers first. I think one of the criteria for being a confirmation teacher is you have to have a long, difficult last name to spell and pronounce. Our lead teacher this year is Lori Aschbacher. Lori. And Dan's name is a little bit easier for me to say and spell. Dan Young, who's been with us for several years now as a teacher. And the last teacher, I actually had to ask two or three times how to say her name before I got it correctly. I still misspell it. She couldn't be here today. She's out of town in business. Megan Veerstaller. Did I say that right? Yeah. Thrilled to death that this was a great team, and they're all coming back next year. So those of you who are in eighth grade now, you have a lot to look forward to. This is a great team. Our confirmation kids this year, see if I can get them all. Aaron Gorham, Why don't you stand up real quick? And you met Ellie Reimer earlier. Ellie. Christian Zastava. Dylan Rice. Eric Milia. Boy, I'm glad they all sat in the area together, too. It helps. Luke Paulson. And way back in the sound booth, our technology engineer, Jacob Mortellaro.
All right. And I know that he thanked some people by name, but we know as a community, as a church family, as a community of faith, that it takes a village. And you all have made an impact in the lives of these children, even if it hasn't been a direct one. Trust me, you have. Children understand, they see, they understand whether or not they belong or not. And this is a church where children very much belong. And so at next service, we will confirm them. If you want to go home and check it out online, you'll be able to see that. Or come back, all right? And so I'm going to call our... we have a little video here that is a recognition of the confirmands. Well, let's receive this video offering.
Our Father everlasting, the all-creating one, God Almighty, and through your Holy Spirit, conceiving Christ the Son, Jesus our Savior. I believe in God our Father. I believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus.
resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus.
And so, Ellie, God bless you. You're representing all of your people with this group of just all these boys. And it just didn't even dawn on me until I just looked at all those little boys up on that screen and the one adorable little girl. And so, friends, let's find the ways to reconfirm our faith, our commitment to Jesus Christ. And as I'm inviting the praise team to come up, why don't we join our voices together in a song? Let us stand and sing Who You Say I Am.
That the highest King would welcome me. I was lost, but he brought me in. Oh, his love for me. Oh, his love for me. Who the Son set runs deep. While I was a slave to sin, Jesus died for me. Yes, he died for me. Who the Son sets free, oh, is free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I. Not forsaken, I am who you say I am. You are for me, not against me. I am who you say I am.
I am chosen, not forsaken.
Yes, I am, and yes, so are you, beautifully created in the image of our God, and that image is the God of love and grace, and as God's people, that should be our defining characteristic. And so as you go forth this week, remember the vows that you have taken. Contemplate on the ways in which you are feeding your spiritual journey through all the milestones of life. As the ushers escort you, you're going to be invited to come out this side door to place your contact cards. And if you took one of our pens in there, any offering or change for mission can go in there as well. And your hands will then be sanitized and you can go out. May God bless you this week. Amen.